Friends, welcome back to Virtual Sunday School. We are so glad that you are joining us again, whether you are watching this from home or whether you are here on campus with us, with your friends in our Sunday school classes. We just love that you guys are plugging in every Sunday and hearing these stories, which are God's story, but they're also our story too. These are kind of our family stories because we are all a part of God's family, and these stories teach us about who we are. We're going to meet a new character this week. His name is Moses. So remember last week we finished our story about Joseph. And even though Joseph's brothers had done something really ugly to him, he forgave them. And they bring their whole family and they come to live in Egypt. And everything is awesome because the Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, he's great friends with Joseph. He knows Joseph. He loves Joseph. But many years pass and a new Pharaoh, a new king comes to power, and Joseph dies, and years pass by and there's a new situation. The Hebrew people, Joseph's family, they've become slaves to Pharaoh, to the king, and that's where we pick up our story for this week. This is the story of baby Moses, and you can find it in your Spark Story Bible. You can also find it in the NIV Adventure Bible. We're starting a new book of the Bible today. We've been telling stories from Genesis, the first book in the Bible, and now we're switching over to Exodus. And this story picks up in Exodus chapter 2. But if you want to hear the story of how God's people became slaves, you can read about that in Exodus chapter 1. Our story begins this week. It says, Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, was afraid. He was rich and powerful and scared. What could he be scared of? Well, strangely enough, Pharaoh was scared of God's people, the Hebrews, Joseph's family. He thought there were too many of them. And he was afraid that they would try to become more powerful than he was. Y'all, let's take a pause here for just a second. Sometimes when we make decisions because we're afraid, we don't make faithful decisions. If you're scared, you should talk to an adult or talk to God, pray about it. But when we make decisions out of fear, sometimes we make bad decisions. And that's what happened to Pharaoh. To make sure that the Hebrews had no power, Pharaoh made them his slaves and ordered them to work very hard. Even worse, he demanded that all of the Hebrew baby boys should be drowned in the Nile River. Because of this, God's people were terribly afraid too, and everyone in Egypt was afraid. During this fearful time, a baby was born to a Hebrew mother. She loved her baby boy, and of course, she wanted him to live. The baby's mother kept him safe by making a floating basket for him. She put her baby in the basket and hid it in the water in the plants at the edge of the Nile River. The baby's big sister, Miriam, hid near the shore and watched over the basket. What happened next was really amazing. Y'all, let's think for a minute. What could have happened? There are so many things that could have happened, right? The basket could have tipped over. The baby could have fallen out. The wrong person could have picked up the basket. But none of those bad things are what happened. God intervened and something amazing happened. Pharaoh's daughter, the princess, came down to the river to take a bath. She saw the basket among the water and the plants and asked her servant to go and get it. When she opened the basket, she was surprised to see a baby boy crying. This must be one of the Hebrews' children, said Pharaoh's daughter. He's awfully cute. Wouldn't it be fun to keep him? Ha, thought Miriam, his sister, I can help her. Miriam bravely stepped out of her hiding place. I could probably find someone to help take care of that baby for you until he's a little bit older, she said. That would be perfect, said Pharaoh's daughter. Miriam was excited to tell her mother the good news. The baby's mother took good care of him. When he was old enough, he went to live with Pharaoh's daughter. Miriam and her mother prayed he would be safe with her. I think I will name him Moses, said Pharaoh's daughter, because I took him out of the water. Moses lived in Pharaoh's palace until he grew up to be a man. During that time, life became worse and worse for the Hebrews. Eventually, however, Moses helped free God's people so they could leave Egypt. Now there was something besides fear for God's people. There was hope. Guys, how cool is this story? God did something amazing. He used Pharaoh's daughter to save Moses so he wouldn't drown in the river. Y'all, God has amazing and big plans for all of us too. God draws us out. He calls us to do amazing things for him. We're going to keep reading the story of Moses for the next couple of weeks, so I hope you come back each Sunday as we see what happens next in God's story. We hope you guys have a great week. We're praying for you, and we look forward to seeing you again soon. Bye, friends.